Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are continuing with our journey, learning and living with the builders of this nation, of our ummah. And today we're going to be living with a unique one, a Sayyida Safiyyah bint Huyay. Uniqueness about her, that she was Jewish. She came from a Jewish family. She was born, raised in Medina. And this woman was described as the following: very beautiful. And this was actually described by another woman, Umm Sulaym, who prepared her for the marriage. And she described her as extremely beautiful. She was very intelligent. This described as also being very generous, that she arranged money for her family and for the poor. Sayyida Safiyyah was married before she married the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. She is the daughter of the leader of the Jewish tribe in Medina, Banu Nadir. She actually married twice. One time she got divorced, and the second time she became widowed. At one point in her life, the Jews were removed from Medina to the outskirts of Medina, and she had to leave, and she stayed away from her home. In one of the battle with Banu Nadir, her father was killed and her husband was killed. She was actually taken as a capture of war. And at that point, even before marrying Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, she accepted Islam. Now she is a widow, away from the family, a new religion, and a capture of war. And this is a woman who was the daughter of a leader. What a test. And Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam wanted to marry her for many reasons. Number one is to bring the tribes of Medina together, bring her back her honor as an honorable woman, daughter of a tribe leader. When the time came in for Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam to marry her, he actually gave her the choice. And we all these days love to have choices. So let's see what choice he gave her. He said, "Ya Safiyyah," the meaning of, you came from a noble family and you still have some of your family at the outskirts of Medina. If you want, I will set you free and you go back to your family. Or if you want, I'll keep you. And not only keep you, but I will marry you and you will be one of the mothers of the believers. And she said the following: "O Prophet of Islam, I admired Islam and I admired you before you called me to be the wife or to be a Muslim. I have no interest in Judaism and I have no father or a brother to go back for. And if you give me the choice between Judaism and freedom versus Islam, I am not going to choose anything but Islam. And by Allah, the Prophet, peace be upon him, and Islam is way more beloved to me than Judaism and my family." What did Sayyida Safiyyah went through because she accepted Islam and because she married the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam? Something many women will feel. The other wives were jealous of her, including Sayyida Aisha, including Sayyida Zainab bin Jahsh, which both were very beautiful. And the jealousy was to the point where they used to indirectly say things to her that hurts. So let's share a story. The wives of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam found it difficult to accept her. So we can feel how she felt. Again, she grew up in Medina. The others all grew up in Mecca. She was Jewish. Most of them were Muslims. Her parents, but actually especially the father, was one of the main enemies to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. So they did not accept her. And sometimes they were not shy of declaring their unacceptance. One of the challenges she had, even they questioned her sincerity in faith. So they used to indirectly remind her that she was still Jewish. Sayyida Aisha used to be jealous of her to the point. Sayyida Safiyyah was a good cook. So one day she cooked a meal and sent it to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. He was carrying the dish, and Sayyida Aisha made it a point to break the dish. And he looked at her, and she said, "How can I make this up for Safiyyah?" He said, "You go and get the same dish, you cook, and you send it to her." And Sayyida Aisha is commenting that I did this because I was jealous. Human beings naturally feel this feeling. And also out of the jealousy, one time, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam was mentioning Safiyyah. And Sayyida Aisha looked at him and says, "Enough, you mention Safiyyah. She is this and this," indirectly indicating she was short. And Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said to Sayyida Aisha, "You said a word. If it would be mixed with the water of the sea will be polluted." And this is how he was telling her that this is not a nice thing to say. And we always have to remember, this is a teaching for us also. We don't belittle people and call them names or call them with their description, even if it is true, but the way we say it, to put them down. Sayyida Hafsa bint Umar also had a not very much acceptance to Sayyida Safiyyah. And she called her the Jewish. So Sayyida Safiyyah went to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam crying. And she said, "They call me this." And he said, "Go back and tell them, my father is a prophet," that's Sayyidina Musa. "My uncle is a prophet," that's Sayyidina Harun. "And my husband is a prophet," which is the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. "So why you are looking or saying this to me?" One of the rulings of Hajj related to the woman during her menstruation was actually done and legislated because of an incident happened to Sayyida Safiyyah. So she was in Hajj with the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. And in the last day, as they finished the Hajj and they were planning to go back to Medina, they told the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, "Safiyyah has not done yet the farewell tawaf, circumambulation around the Kaaba." And he said, "Why not?" They said, "She has menstruation." And then he said, "Ahabisatunahi? Are we going to be waiting till she finish?" And then he said, "If she's menstruating, then the farewell tawaf is not an obligation for her, and we can all leave." And up till this day, this is one of the rulings. When the woman gets her menstruation, the farewell tawaf is not an obligation on her anymore. She was a noble woman, loved Islam, went through tests because of her acceptance to Islam, trials, but she was sincere. She loved the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. This is narrated that during his final days when he was sick, she looked at him and says, "I wish what you are feeling and suffering is given to me and you will be free and healthy of any pain and any suffering." The wives of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, when she said that, they looked at each other. And the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam looked at them and said, "By Allah, I know Safiyyah is truthful and loyal. And what she said, she meant it." She was very generous. She donated all what she had to the poor, to the needy, and supported her family. She passed away 52 years after Hijrah at age 60 in Medina. She was buried in Baqi'ah. She passed during the time of Muawiyah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us so dedicated to our deen, even if we have to leave the other religion, be different from our family, or we go through difficulties during our marriages, but we still stay firm and sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.